Good morning, everyone. I know you're probably think Iain Lee's going to be on the microphone now. It's his producer, Will. We've been we're trying to get hold of Iain. He's not here yet. So we'll just play a song. Morning, everyone. It's still producer Will here. Just trying to work out whereabouts Iain is. I don't think he's too far away, but we're hoping he's going to be in very shortly. Still, obviously, plenty to come in the show. Hopefully he'll be here, you know, sort of sooner rather than later. But
morning.
We are. Oh, there
morning.
He is. There he
Sorry.
Is.
Oh. Can I? Right. Morning.
Morning.
You are Will.
Yeah. Nice to meet you, Iain. How are you
Lovely.
Doing?
Got Dr. Kimball here. Nice to see you. The fugitive. Could I get? There was a chair here. Where has the chair gone?
Just here.
Right.
Sorry.
So you've got the chair.
Yeah, there's
right.
the chair. Sorry.
Is okie dokie. Thank you very much. Sorry. Oh, nearly swat. Haven't been on the radio for 2 years. Right.
All right.
Absolutely fine.
Yeah.
Sorry
yeah.
for being late. Sorry.
Okay.
Sorry for being late. To the listeners. These things happen. It's life.
Yeah, it is.
It's
yeah.
life.
Absolutely.
And it happens. So, I've got my laptop here. It's all good. We're all good.
Yeah,
don't panic.
All okay, yeah, that's fine.
It's, here's the thing. It's just radio. It doesn't really matter. Plug that into there. Right. Okay. Which button? That one, right? Okay. Why are you not saying anything, Dr. Kimball? Oh, Dr. Kimball is a secret. He's a fugitive. Right. Where's that? There we go. Oh, yeah. Let me just get into the vibe. Let me just... Which one is the laptop? Is that one there? Okay, let me just check this works. Right, can't play that. It's ugly. Right, so... Join me in prayer. Dear Tony Blackburn, the saint of radio, I haven't been on the air for 2 years. I've been sacked from every job I've ever had. Please make today's radio show go at the very least okay. Don't allow me to sink to the depths of Steve Allen or Julia Hartley Brewer. Let's just try and aim for like a Nick Abbott. Not Steve Wright, he's got the sack. Okay, I'm going to press a button because this is going terribly. There we go. That's a song. I don't know what you're supposed to say in these situations. That was a song. It's fading out. It's gone. I'm bored of that now. Right, good morning, everybody. This is Iain Lee. This is Jack FM. I haven't been on the radio for 2 years, so I'm really out of breath. Jeez. You're producer Will.
I am producer Will.
Nice to meet you.
A lot more relaxed now.
Chill out, man.
Yeah.
Just chill out. Just
I
chill
am.
Out
I
and
will,
enjoy
man.
The vibe.
Yeah.
Let's play. So, I tell you what, let's sound professional, shall we? We're going to sound professional by having a little bit of background music. Hang on a minute. Stay cool. There we go. There
very
it is.
Good,
there we go. We got the faders, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to a new dawn. That makes it sound like some kind of fascist organisation, which it is in Greece. Already going down a Greek fascist rabbit hole. That's not a great start to the show. This is not what Oxford wants. Good morning, dear listener. This is Iain Lee. You remember I stole some strawberries on a reality TV show and I fell down a well and I got attacked by an owl. All different things that actually happened. I would like to say, first of all, I'm going to stand up and we're going to salute 15 years of Trevor Marshall, ladies and gentlemen.
Absolutely.
15 years of Trevor Marshall. Thank you very much, Trevor Marshall. There we go. We're even doing the round of applause for you. Trevor is going to be on in the afternoons. Will, what time is Trevor going to be on?
He's going to be on 3 till 6, mate.
Ooh.
He'll be knocking off.
So some of you will be like going, oh, geez, man. I've been woken up by Trevor Marshall for the last 15 years. Who is this idiot that doesn't even have the decency to turn up on time? And you don't have a clock in this studio, do you?
We actually don't.
Wowzers. Wowzers. We're going to start a fundraiser so Jack FM can have a digital clock in the studio where the blooming presenter can sit. Anyway, so there'll be lots of you going, this guy's rubbish, he's shouting and he's an idiot and he's getting on my nerves. That's okay. I am going to give you one show's grace to phone up and moan that I am not Trevor Marshall. Okay, you got one show's grace to phone up and be as rude to me as you want because Trevor is not here. I've got no problem with that. I'm going to give you the phone number. There's a phone number, ladies and gentlemen. Imagine that, it's a phone number. This is going to be a phone-in show, by the way. I should have said that before I said that. So, pens and papers at the ready, boys and girls. 01865 575 106, right? 01865 575 106. That's the phone number. If you want to phone up, you can phone up about anything, right? It's going to be one of those kind of chilled, relaxed shows where you can call in about absolutely anything you want. However, I'm giving you one day's grace, one show's grace to phone up and go, yeah, but you're not Trevor Marshall, who is brilliant, by the way, and gave me my first ever gig in radio in 1997. That's how old he is. I was 12 at the time. So, 01-865-575-106 is the telephone number if you want to have a whinge, a justifiable whinge, that I'm not Trevor Marshall. This is Jack FM. Hang on a minute. We don't want that. Jeez, man. Already this is a car crash, right? How do I... Will, how do I skip stuff on the computer that plays the songs? Is there like a skip button?
You just press that one again.
Okay, but... Okay, all right.
Ian Lee's Rude Awakening.
We're going to the ads.
Is that good? Ads are good?
Good.
Let's go to the ads.
From the Oxfordshire experts. Search STL Oxfordshire.
Images of Elon Musk and videos about cryptocurrency were posted. And that button's not working.
Hang on a minute. No. Hang on. Everybody just cool out. I'm so sorry. This is my first time doing this. Joe, it's really nice to meet you. So do I hit the button, do I?
I hit the button, but well, I just hit the button twice and nothing happened.
Why now?
Help me out.
I've got absolutely no idea. I don't know what to do. This is such a great way to meet you, Joe.
Isn't it, Jess?
Sorry.
I knew something would happen.
Well, of course, that's rude. Now, come in, Dr. Kimball. What fader did I have down that we were supposed... Honestly, I swear to God, by the end of September, we will be getting there. Okay, she hit the button and it didn't work. So I'm supposed to hit the button every time. Okay, so he's doing it via the language of mime. Jeez. All right, I'll hit the button.
Jack FM Sport.
With ASM Auto Recycling. Old car more battered than an ex-England rugby player. ASM will buy it.
It was a dramatic race at the British Grand Prix, which ended in a win for Spain's Carlos Sainz. There was a major crash on the opening lap, which saw Zhou Guanyu's F1 car flip over multiple times and hit a barrier. Elsewhere, Great Britain's men's and women's eights both tasted glory on finals day at the Henley Regatta. The men racing as Oxford Brookes University and Leander Club took the oldest trophy in the event yesterday in the first victory by a GB8 since 2015. I'm going to need the button again, if you don't mind.
Give me the finger.
Which one?
Jack FM weather.
Cloudy but dry, plenty of sunshine and a light breeze. Highs are 21 today, but warming up through the week to a hot 24 or 25 by Friday.
Could you try the button, see if it works now? No!
Nope.
Ian Lee's
okay,
rude.
Hang on a minute. Right. This is an absolute car crash of a radio show.
106 Jack FM.
Right. So, hello, Joe. I'm Ian. Nice to meet you. Literally just met this morning.
Yeah.
I would like to apologise for any technical cock-ups. That's Will's fault. It's not our fault. Mm-mm. We're what we like to call the talent. Anybody listening to this is going, what? No, idiots. Me, not you. That was rude. And I'm guessing you like to do the news on the hour and on the half hour, not 5 minutes late.
If possible.
I'm going to work on that.
Thank you.
I promise that that's going to happen some point today. I'm going to hit this button. There we go. Thank you very much. Yep. Painfully staged. Morning, everybody. Here we go. And there we go. We're in. Suddenly, we're in. Play. Oh, my hotkey didn't work. Let's try this one. That's terrible. I've deleted one of my hotkeys, and the other one is playing. But we have actually deleted a hotkey. That means nothing to you, and nor should it mean anything to you. But to me... It's the end of the flipping world. Okay. Morning, dear listener. This is Ian Lee. If you're expecting it to kind of get slick at any point, That ain't going to happen, I'm afraid. This is as good as it gets. Good news. This is now a phone-in show, and you can phone in about anything you want. You can even phone in for one day to complain that I'm not the brilliant Trevor Marshall, all right? You can do that. One day you got. But Iain, what's the phone number? If you listen, I will tell you it. It's 01-865-575-106. Producer Will is here. Good morning, Producer Will.
Good morning.
Do you want to play a dangerous game?
Yeah, I'd love
to. We're not going to do anything until someone phones in. Now, we could be here until next Thursday doing this, right? So, 01-865-575-106. Who is going to be the first caller to Iain Lee's Rude Awakening, the whole new regime here at Jack FM? Who is going to be the first caller? Now, we might not get any calls, in which case, the next 27 minutes is going to be uncomfortable. I was worried I was going to say a swear word then if you broke down the word uncomfortable, but you don't. It sounds like a little bit of a swear. 01-865-575-106. Oh my God, people are phoning in! Take the phone calls! Take the phone calls!
It's on your end.
How do I do it? Just click. Oh, they've gone! We nearly caught them. What do I do? Do I just click on it when they phone? Yeah, I just click.
Yeah. You might have to go across.
Why are you not taking the phone calls? You're the goddamn producer.
I know. I'm sorry.
What is it? All right. Okay,
I'm a bit stressed this week.
It's like tickling trout. This is like tickling. Have you ever tickled a trout?
It's
how you catch trout. I'm doing it. Let me do it up here where you can see. You stand in a river that has trout in and you tickle them and they think it's water and then you pull them out and you eat them. Right. Okay. So we missed. That was slick. I'm ready to catch it. 01-865. Let me make sure I've got the right. That's the phone fader there. Okay, here we go. 01-865-575-106. Who is going to be the first person that calls and actually manages to get on it? So we're just gonna ride the vibe. We're just gonna wait. I'm here. Don't come. Where are you going?
I'm going to come round.
Don't come round.
I just want to make sure we can answer them. Hang on.
This is the most. No, don't play. That's
no, no,
the.
No, no. Oh, that's the drop call. Right. Okay.
Okay. All right. Right, okay, here we go. Okay. All right. We got a call. So I just click on it.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. We have a caller. Hello, caller. You're the first caller on Jack FM. Who is this, Blaz? Please.
Hello, and woohoo, 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 first caller. My name's Judy from Southend, and I welcome you to the morning show.
Oh, thank. What did you say your name was? Judy?
Judy. I was Tootie. The lady that wanted to deck Jim one in the panto. Oh, yes, I did.
It's behind you. I never remember the panto. I have no idea what she's talking about, but I like her. I like you a lot. So thank you for welcoming me. What would you? This is your show. This is your show. What would you like from the show? What would you like from the show?
Stupid stuff.
That's not a nice way to speak about my producer, but a point taken. I tell you what. Have
a lot of fun to begin with in the morning. It's going to be not too early, about 8 o'clock.
Well, I mean, you don't have.
Come on,
it starts.
I'm not that wide awake.
So, would you like? Do you want the first hour between 7 and 8 to be kind of tepid and moribund and a little bit flat?
Well, yeah. Well, between 7 and 8, just lull us in.
I'll lull you in. Without lull. And then 8, I'll lull you in.
And from 8 o'clock, because I get rid of the brats, we can play the headbanging music.
Oh, we're going to play some. Oh, man. We're going to play some headbanging music.
Excellent.
Would you like
to? I just want to welcome you.
May the gods bless you. Do you want to play a little game with me?
Oh, gosh. Go on, then.
Have you ever played the yes-no game?
Yes.
Oh, mate, you're out on the first go. That's terrible. Iain Lee's. Here we go. All right. Okay, fine. Right, I'm not very good at. There's this thing in radio, it's called back announcing. You can do a back anno. You've got to do a back anno, right? And it's where you name the song and what do they call it? The group. That's what they call it. I am the worst at back annos. Back annos. How much for a back anno? £25. Okay, I'm in. I am the worst at announcing the songs, right? So I apologise in advance. also, when it's a song like that, you don't need me to do it, right? That would be patronising for me to do it. This is Iain Lee. This is the new, I don't want to say improved Jack FM, because that's rude to the brilliant Trevor Marshall, who you can hear between what time, Will?
3 and 6.
Okay,
I said 6.
That's producer Will, yeah. By the way, and we're going to find out. He's young. He doesn't know films. And at some point throughout our career together, it's a year contract. I give it 3 months. We'll be finding out. We're going to just throw film titles at him. And all right, let's do it. Have you? Let me try and think. Have you ever seen Enter the Dragon?
No.
What happens in Enter the Dragon, do you think?
I'm not sure I can say on Breakfast Radio.
Okay. Just give it a guess. So it's Enter the Dragon. So what do you think? Someone pictures you that, hey, Will, I got an idea for a movie. It's called Enter the Dragon. And you go, I stop you there. I think I know what happens in it.
Okay.
What happens in it?
Okay, so there's a dragon.
Right.
It goes in some sort of castle somewhere.
Okay, yep.
Has to be slayed.
Yep.
It's dragon slayed.
Yep.
Slay dragon.
Okay.
In a castle.
Okay, that's okay. This is what we're dealing with, dear listener. Right. So, very quickly, the phone number. I want phone calls and I want to talk to people. Now we know where to look when the because I know some people called and we missed them. So, 01-865-575-106. 01-865-575-106. We want people to play the yes/no game. We want people just to call in, just to have a chat. It's morning. Let's have a chat
as well.
Iain Lee's Rude Awakening on Jack FM. A slice of radio toast.
Hang on now.
With just a gentle spreading of We Can't Believe It's Not Better.
Thank you, Dom. That's Dom.
106 Jack FM.
That's Dom. That's Mr. Dom Jolly. Joe, right. We were 4 minutes late for your news there. That is unforgivable. So, here's what's going to happen. At 8:30, we are going to be bang on 8:30. That's happening.
Okay.
That is my promise to you. So
I better not be late.
Yeah, well, I was going to say that the mistakes in the first one were yours, but that would be ungentlemanly to do that.
But you said it and now everyone knows. So
I flippin' did, didn't I? That's terrible, terrible behaviour. I do apologise. One of the most awkward interviews I ever did was with the Ting Tings. The Ting Tings.
It's an awkward interview. Very awkward interview.
Seriously awkward interview with the Tintings. They were probably having a tough time, you know. They were in the twilight of their careers. Can you imagine? That's what how Andy Murray is being described now. The twilight of his career. Sweet Lord. Where does that put me? I mean, geez. Anyway, the Tintings, you know, it was just a tough interview. Let's go through a list of tough interviews. The Tintings from the Tintings. Ray Davies. From the Kinks. Oh, and Daniel Bedingfield. Oh, my God, the Daniel Bedingfield. Oh. I think I may have been the problem with the Daniel Bedingfield. Good morning, dear listener. This is Iain Lee. This is Iain Lee's Rude Awakening on Jack FM. It's lovely to have you here. If you are here, I mean, some of you may have switched off. Trevor will be back at 3 o'clock, so don't worry. He's not gone. As this show evolves, it's like day one, you know, and I was late for the beginning, yeah, so the stuff happens. As this show evolves, I want this to become a phone-in show, right? And you can call in about absolutely anything you want. And you hear that as a listener, you think, but I need a hook. I need something to call in. So for this morning, I'm going to throw out, if you want to have a moan that I'm not Trevor, today is your amnesty, your one-day amnesty, where you're allowed to call in and do that. We're also going to play the yes/no game. You know, it's a little bit corny, but you can call in about absolutely anything, right? So there's a new phone number for you to learn. Write this down, stick it on your fridge, stick it up your jacksie. I don't really care, but know it. 01-865 575-106, like the numbers on the radio. No one uses a radio anymore. 01-865-575-106. That's the phone number. Oh, I want to tell you about the... Have you ever heard of a Karen Cafe?
Oh, I have heard of these, I think.
I went to a Karen Cafe at the weekend. If you've never heard of a Karen Cafe, I mean... It's where you go in and the staff, they're all called Karens, and Darren's, that was it. The waiters and waitresses, they are so rude. So rude. I mean, this is a morning show, so I got to be careful. We rocked up. What do you even want? We booked a table. Soap in what? It got worse than that. As we sat at the table, the waiter threatened to put something in our burgers that should not be put. I'm trying to tread very carefully because there's young ears listening. He threatened to put something in our burgers that should not be in a burger. Will, I'm going to mime to you what he threatened to put in there.
Right.
Okay. Yeah. There we go. That was it.
Okay.
That was it. Yeah. It was that. Joe. Yeah. Joe, if you missed that, it was this. He threatened to put that in our burgers. Wowzers.
Wow.
Wowzers. Oh, there's a... Hang on a minute. Let me just take this. We haven't really got time for this. We are going to be late. Hello, caller.
Hello. Good morning.
Good morning. Who is this, please?
This is Mark from Oxford.
Mark from Oxford, a regular listener. Are you here to complain that I'm not Trevor? You are allowed to.
I'm here to complain a little bit that you're not Trevor, but one thing in particular.
Okay.
The background music.
Yeah?
It's terrible. It's sending us to sleep.
It's doing what?
It's sending us to sleep.
It's when you say us, who is us, please?
Me, everyone I'm working with, and I think everyone in Oxfordshire too.
Okay, have you spoken to everyone in Oxfordshire?
Not at the moment.
Let's take everyone from Oxfordshire out of that equation. What do you do for a living? Is it important that you're awake?
It is very important. I put traffic lights out for a living.
You put traffic lights out?
Yes, temporary for roadwork.
Okay, well, thanks for doing that. Okay, so what would you like in the background instead?
Something a bit more old school, maybe a little bit of 70s rock. That's good.
Okay, well, that's not going to happen. So I apologise.
No worries.
Thanks very much for your call. I do often wonder, people like Sandy Tom, right? That's a great song. That is a great song. What is Sandy Tom doing this precise second in time? At 8:25 on Monday, the 4th of July. You know, where is Sandy Tom and what is Sandy? And I'm not doing it as in one of those one hit. People mock and laugh at one hit wonders. How many hits have you had? Huh? How many hits have you had? I would love to have had one big hit. Some of the pop stars just kind of don't want to be pop stars anymore. I'm friends with Narina Paolo, and she was a big star for a while, and then I think she decided I'd rather tone it down. Imani Coppola, wow, legend of a cowgirl. That was some song, and she just went, yeah, I don't want to be a pop star anymore. I'm going to go and do stuff on my own. We had someone complaining that the beds were a little bit they're a little bit too slow for them. So let's try this one. There we go. That's faster, right? That's faster. This is for all of you people putting out the temporary traffic lights. Hope you're enjoying it, Mark. 01-865-575-106 is the phone number. Call in about absolutely anything you want. I really don't care. I want this show to be about us having a chat about absolutely anything. We're also playing the yes-no game. You ever played the yes-no game before, Will?
Not sure.
Straight in, are you?
Yeah, mate.
There we go. Thank you. Yeah, mate. There we go. You've got to be... I nearly swore then. Jeez. I haven't been on the radio for 2 years, right? I've been streaming. I'm nearly 50. What do you think I am? Dan TDM, there's a reference for the kids, guys. I have been streaming. Not steaming. Streaming. I was steaming for a bit of it, but 18 months sober, ladies and gentlemen, but that's by the by. So I've been streaming. So I've been doing stuff under my stairs on the internet, right? And I didn't know this. You're allowed to swear on the internet. Yeah, oh yeah, you're allowed to swear. And so I kind of got in this sweary kind of frame of mind. So I need to watch myself, and I need to watch my language, because, well, you know, I know what I want to do. In the next half hour, we want to start giving away ages, right? We're giving away actual ages. I want to get listeners aged between 0 and 100. That's what we're going to do. So if you are an age between 0 and 100, and I suspect most of you are going to be, if you give us a call, you can own that age. We can only have one 39-year-old. Like a 39-year-old's listening to this, jeez. We can only have one 3-year-old. We can only have one 100-year-old. 01865 575106.
Iain Lee's Rude Awakening with ST.
Iain Lee's Rude Awakening, the episodic breakfast show. It's a serial, you see. 106 Jack FM.
It's not it! Now, Joe, can I ask, do you know sports? No, it's, and I don't want to put you on the spot. This is not like Sports Challenge. I don't know sports. Will, do you know sports?
I do know sports.
Right, so it's Wimbledon, right?
Yeah.
Who was the tennis player last week that was getting all stroppy?
Nick Kyrgios.
Did you see this? He won a game.
Yeah.
And then he did a press conference. He went, yeah, I won that so the press learned to respect me. Did you see that?
I haven't heard this.
Did you hear that?
I think it might have been Kyrgios. I'm not 100% sure.
Well, if we are libelling that gentleman, I would like to apologise on behalf of Jack FM's lawyers. But he won. See if we can find this clip, right? Not this precise second, because we're not that good yet. Yet. But he went, yeah, they've won this. And hopefully this will teach the press a little bit of respect. That's some attitude, right?
Mm-hmm.
That's some attitude. Will, your challenge is to find that clip.
Okay.
Otherwise, I will literally kill you. Okay. There we go.
Lee's Rude Awakening on Jack FM. If this doesn't wake you up, we can't help you.
Thank you very much indeed, Dom. 01 86. Well, I'm so out of breath, and you know what I did was I just stood up and sat down. 01 865 575 106 is the phone number.
Oh,
that's the wrong one. That was me. I'm sorry. That was me. We're going here. Hello, Charlie.
Hello, Iain. How are you?
I'm. You know what? Can I be honest with you, Charlie?
Of course you can.
I'm a multi-award-winning radio presenter, and I am absolutely bricking it this morning. But apart from that, I'm okay. What's going on for you?
Nothing really. I'm procrastinating. I'm meant to be writing my dissertation right now, but I'd like to claim an age if I can.
Yes, please. You can. Let me guess your age. I'm the best at guessing ages. You've given me a slight clue with dissertation. You're 24.
I was 24, 16 years ago, yes.
Oh, whoa, hang on a minute, let me do the maths. So, 24, well, so you're 40?
I was 40 last week.
Happy birthday to Charlie. There's actually a birthday song. Because what's your dissertation on?
It's on breastfeeding support for identified small for gestational age babies with the aim of reducing neonatal mortality in Stoke on Trent.
Wow! First of all, that's very niche. But second of all, well done. That sounds that's incredible. And I have no questions about that.
Good, because I don't know the answers.
Oh, okay. Well, so how far? What's your dissertation? 5,000? 10,000?
8,000.
Okay. All right. And how many words have you got so far?
About
375. Oh, no, Charlie! Oh, no! That's a big old daunting thing. When does it have to be handed in by?
By 1 o'clock on Thursday.
Hang on a minute. I've got a thing I can do here. Oh, no, that didn't work. Hang on, I've got to play something that's going to sound... Here we go. Right, here we go. This is what... When has it got to be handed in by?
1 o'clock on Thursday.
Flip, it didn't work. Hang on, stay there. We'll try it again. Here we go. Right, one more time.
Okay.
One more time. Here we go. When has it got to be handed in by?
1 o'clock on Thursday.
I'm just going to do it. You'll hear it over the speaker.
Okay.
It's Barry Manilow singing Woman, Are You Mad? Which is probably a little bit out of order. All right, listen.
Thank you.
You're 40. 40 is yours. No one else can claim 40. And if you meet anybody who is 40 years old, they owe you £5, okay? And that's legally binding.
Okay. Okay, I have a couple of friends who were 40 this year as well, so they already owe me then.
Well, go on, claim that money, Charlie. Could you let us know at the end of the week if you will, might not. Could you let us know when you've done it?
Of course I will, yes.
Excellent stuff. Charlie, best of luck. Thank you for calling.
Thank you, and best of luck for you for the show too.
Thank you very much indeed. There we go. 01 865 575 106 is the telephone number if you want to give us a call. This is Iain Lee's Rude Awakening. We're giving away ages 40. It's gone already.
Iain Lee's Rude. Oh, sorry. Iain Lee's
Thank
Rude
you, Dom.
Awakening.
Thank you, Dom Jolly.
106 Jack FM.
01865 575 106. We're giving away ages. We also seem to be talking to Mark quite a lot. Good morning, Mark.
Good morning, Iain.
Yes, it's not the best line, so let's make this sharpish. What would you like to complain about now?
More, I would like to claim an age.
Oh! Mark!
You're a pervert.
Okay, right, let's claim an age. What age would you like, Mark?
I would like 31, please.
Oh, shut up. You're not 31.
I'm 31.
Shut up! You sound about 52.
I know. It's been a rough childhood in the country, guys.
Right, listen. So you put out the temporary traffic lights, right? You can't be that busy, because there's not that many of them.
No, we're holding up Swindon at the moment, which is a good thing.
Good. At some point in the next few months, Oxford, led by me, is going to declare war on Swindon, so they better watch out. Right, so you want 31, Mark. Mark, yes, it's yours. You've got it.
Thank you very much.
You're very, very welcome. Thank you. I didn't think we were going to win Mark over. I thought Mark was going to be a tricksy one, and we've won him over. We just by the simple act of giving away ages. So far, we want 0 to 100, right? So if you've got a bebes, then call up. If you've got little kids, let's get some kids on the radio. When was the last time we had kids on Jack FM? Listen, there's nothing better than having a six-year-old on, being all shy and not really saying very much. We are giving away ages between 0 and 100. 31... and 40, they've gone already. Hello, caller.
Yeah, it's Gordon the Trucker.
Gordon the Trucker, Trevor Marshall has warned me about you. He's told me not to touch you with a 6-foot barge pole.
Oh!
He told me... Actually, here's what he said.
Hey, this guy's good.
He is a big fan of yours. Gordon the Trucker, how may I help you?
I'm 66.
66? I said that. Yes. Why do I sound so surprised? How rude. 66, Gordon the Trucker, it's yours. What this means is, if you meet any other... Should you be driving a truck at 66?
Yes, I had my medical Saturday. I'm okay.
I'm 50 next year, right? And I'm getting the letter saying, would you like to come in for your annual health check? It's like, because I'm old, right? It's because I'm old.
Yeah.
Was there anything that you didn't do as well as on the health check that you would have liked to?
No, right? Everything's okay, blood pressure, eyesight, everything's all okay.
Okay, well, this is great. We've got a safe trucker on the road. Can I ask a question? Do truckers, have you ever seen the film Convoy?
Yes.
It's a great film, right? Chris Christopherson, yeah. and all of the, and Ernest Borgnine. Do you guys still use CB radios?
No, not on air trucks, we don't know. But they do, some of them do.
I miss the days of, I bought a CB radio about 2 months ago. No one's on the CB anymore.
I think it's Channel 9
left
to go on.
Channel 9. Okay. Yeah. All right. Well, I'll have some of that. Gordon, 66 is yours.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you. Drive safely, please. And, hang on a minute. I wonder if he's going to have beef with the traffic light guy.
Yeah, maybe we could get Mark and Gordon on.
Get those two on to have a fight. Already in the first show, I'm trying to get the callers to fight each other, and I'm declaring war on Swindon. I don't know if this is the look that when the bosses of Jack went, you know what? We need to revitalise. We need to get someone new in. And can I just say how great it is? How great it is that finally we have a space for white middle-aged men to talk freely, because god damn it, there's not enough of them on radio.
Ram your hot dog up my pipe.
I have no idea what that's in reference to. I can only apologize.
Exciting news, exciting news.
I'd forgotten all about that song, and there's a reason why. Very exciting news, right? After 9 o'clock, we are joined by one of Britain's top psychic mediums, and they are going to tell me whether the spirits think this show is going to be a success or it's going to be a failure. So after 9 o'clock, do you believe in the spirits, Will? Do you believe in all of that stuff?
Yeah, for the sake of this. Yeah,
no, well, don't give me for the sake of this. I'm taking from that you're not a believer.
Not massively, mate, no.
You never seen a ghost?
No, not that I can remember. Or
never had the willies put up you? No? Okay.
Different question.
All right. Okay. Well, we are going to have Britain's top psychic medium is coming on just after 9 o'clock, and they will be contacting the spirits, which Will doesn't believe in, and finding out whether this show is going to be a success or a massive balls up.
Jack FM Traffins.
Okay, this is very, very exciting, right? And this is a first for Breakfast Radio. This is my first show on Jack FM. Thank you to everyone who's listened. And, you know, thank you to everyone who's turned off as well. And I haven't done radio for 2 years. So I thought it would be good if we could find out from the celestial plane whether this show is going to be any good. So I looked for Britain's best, brightest, most spot-on psychic medium. They were busy. So, ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome... It's Clinton Baptiste. Hello, Clinton.
Hello, Iain. I will ignore that, what you just said.
I think you probably spirits, should.
No, spirits like to be positive about things, don't they?
Well,
and
I don't know.
In all fairness, talking over me. I joined you
yes.
In good faith
yes.
to give you a prediction, and you're a little bit cheeky there, but don't matter.
It's a little bit of, breakfast but fun, Clinton.
Yes, well, I can tell you now that I'm seeing a lot of very, very tiny figures on the horizon. Those aren't spirits, that's your radar number.
You're a pervert.
Oh, sorry, so... that was an accident. Sorry, that was an accident. They're my radar figures. Okay, the listening figures are tiny. Okay, so that's... Okay.
Anyway, all that aside,
yes.
Very, very good luck to you. I asked someone recently what Iain Lee's up to, and they said, Jack. I said, well, nothing changes. Hopefully they'll get something soon, you know. Anyway, spirit very strong. They're coming through in all shapes and sizes.
Okay, what are the spirits saying?
So, well, celebrities are here, royalty. Hold on. Oh, yeah! Oh, I've got... Oh, the Queen Mother's here.
Oh, God.
Oh, she's saying, oh, I'm right excited about Iain. I tell you what, he's wonderful, him.
Oh.
They're all, I've got various DJs coming through.
Okay.
And they're all being you with the studio today. They're all in there with you.
Wow. Who have we got?
Well, they're all there helping you to rescue the whole thing. You've got okay. Alan Fluff Freeman.
Yep.
Ed Stewpot.
Okay.
The ghost of Chris Evans' career is there with you. And they're saying, this is wonderful, this. They're saying, what's that message? Just passing this off. Verily, thou shalt not crash the vocal and shalt hit into the traffic on time.
Why is Alan Fluff Freeman talking like a Victorian dandy?
Don't ask me.
Okay.
Don't shoot the messenger. I'll be telling you what the police do.
Is that what happens when you die? You become like a Victorian gentleman?
No, you end up on Jack FM. But anyway, in seriousness, I've got Peter Powell here. He's not even dead. And he's with me to the show. He's on me up. So, it's some of the country's best broadcasters. And I tell you what, they want to say a little prayer for
okay.
you.
Okay.
And if you do this for me in your studio, can you hold hands with anyone there?
Well, go hold hand. We're holding
you
hands.
In a studio or in a garage somewhere? In Oxford.
We're in a studio. We're in a very nice studio in Oxford on a trading estate.
Yeah, I wasn't born yesterday. Get one of your fluffers there to just hold your hand.
Get one of my what?
No, it doesn't matter. And I just want you to think about these words.
Okay.
Oh. Masters of the universe, not the 1987.
Yes,
I'm talking about the ghosts and spirits and
yes.
that lurk up in the firmament.
Yeah,
let us pray for Iain's radio gig. Let us hope he don't make a pig's ear of it,
ooh.
But 20 plus years of it, like a Ken Bruce or a Steve Wright, and make sure his reviews aren't too poor.
Okay, thank
but
you.
But above all, Grant, the town brother Iain Lee, can one day get back on TV.
All right, well, that's...
Of
okay.
It's a long shot. He's not as sprightly. The one show, something big, though, let's face it, it's highly unlikely. Now, I know that there's a lot of love out there for you
yes.
in the universe.
Yes.
Not so much around the country, but somewhere in the universe. And the spirits are responding now, and okay. they all say, in all honesty, we do love you so very, very much.
That's magic. That's wonderful.
So good luck. Good luck.
That's wonderful.
And I know it's going to be a very great success.
How's
yes, I'd love to,
your
love
career?
To come on again.
No,
yeah.
Your career, of course, hit the skids quite a while ago. I believe you're having to resort to begging for money on a thing called Patreon. Is that right?
Yes, I do. I do a Patreon show. Very kind of you. A little bit cheeky there. But and if you go to patreon.com/ClintonBaptiste, there's all sorts of things. Maybe even this interview, if we can stick it up there.
You can stick it right up there if you want, Clinton. And you're doing yes. you're doing a tour. Are you coming to Oxford?
Yeah, but, I don't think so. But let's say we are anyway. pretend we are, very much so, and I can't wait to see you all then. If we don't end up there, I'm sure we'll be somewhere close by.
Okay.
It's December, nearly finished.
We're running out of time.
And it's September 2 December.
Quick.
ClintonBaptiste.com.
Okay. We
spirit's fading. Here.
Okay. All right, Clinton.
Was that it?
That was it, yeah.
All right, thank you. Good luck. Good luck. I'm loving the show.
Are you listening? What's your favourite part so far?
The bit where I was on.
Okay, thank you. Goodbye. Exciting stuff. So there's like a WhatsApp number, which is kind of dead now, because we don't do the WhatsApps,
bit, yeah.
but you used to do the WhatsApps. And so many of you have just had the boss come in and say, Iain, we've got loads of feedback for you on the WhatsApps. And I'm like, okay, well, let's hear it. So this is the listener feedback that's been left on the WhatsApp.
Where's my Trevor? Oh, my God, what a show.
Oh.
Please, Trev, where are you?
Morning, Jack. It's Cowboy in town.
Cowboy.
Out on the road.
Yes, mate.
Doing the bins.
Yep.
We're looking for to be cheered up on Monday.
Uh-huh.
We switched the radio on.
Oh.
And what have we got on here? This joker.
Oh.
Who is he? We don't even know who he is.
Okay.
Some joker.
That's right.
Doesn't even know how to press button.
Oh.
God help us.
That's
Bring
true.
Back Trevor.
Okay.
It's Monday.
Not happening.
Get rid of this guy.
Wow.
Morning. Sorry, but what a pile of crap.
Whoa.
I suggest you bring Trevor back.
No.
Or get somebody else. I've moved to another station. Can't stand it. Guy's an absolute...
Jack FM.
Oh, gosh. It was not... Wow. The boss actually put that in the system and said, play it. Whoa, that... Golly, that's rude. That is rude. They make excellent points, though. I do not know how to press a button. Well, I know how to press it. I just don't know when to press it. So that's fair enough. Oh, okay. I don't know how to press that button. All right. Well, that's disappointing. Luckily, that lady isn't listening anymore. So here's the thing, lady. I know you're still listening. They always do.
Jack FM traffic.
Am I talking to myself here?
There is a chance after getting those messages that everyone has switched off. How rude people can be! How rude! If you want to complain, phone me up and complain to me. I don't mind. I'm not going to have a go at you. Just, you know. If you do want to give us a call, there's only half an hour of this nonsense left. Who'd have thunk it? We managed to make it towards the end. The end is in sight. I was late for the first 20 minutes. These things happen. I will set a second. The alarm doesn't always go off on my phone. If you want to call up, we're going to speak to Mandy after the news, but if you want to call up about anything you want, we are giving away ages. You can own an age as a listener, or you can just phone up for a chat. And I really can't stress that enough. You can phone up and you can do anything. When can they do it, Paul?
You can do it right now, please.
Thank you very much indeed. The phone number is 01865 575 106. 01 865 575 106. We could be speaking to you before 10 o'clock. Oh, you know, the odds are we probably won't. That's the way it goes sometimes.
Iain Lee's Rude Awakening with STL. They'll keep your business's IT running smoothly and securely. Search STL Oxfordshire.
Jack FM traffic.
Driven by
25 degrees by Friday.
Okay, now this is, I know that one shouldn't celebrate this, but we hit the news bang on 9:30.
You did. Well done.
Your sarcasm is absolutely appropriate, because imagine, that's the thing that we're proud of. That's the thing I'm proud of, that I was within 3 minutes of the time.
We got. I know, day one as well.
Spot on. Mm-hmm. It's all downhill from here, Joe.
Okay, well, at least I'm prepared for that.
Dave, please do. Thank you very much indeed. This is Iain Lee's Rude Awakening. I should probably play something, but actually I want to go to a call first. Hello, Jimbo.
Good morning, Iain. Good morning.
Good morning, Jimbo. How may I be of assistance to you on this beautiful, beautiful, beautiful day?
It's a glorious day, yeah, hearing you back on the radio. I wanted to claim an age, if I could.
Yes, of course you can.
I wanted to claim 21, but as I'm 45, I better go for that instead.
I think that's more appropriate. 45, jeez, man. I'm 49, right? 50 is staring at us down the barrel.
Well, my wife, Jenna, she says, as soon as I hit the 5 of any age, she did this when I was 35.
Yeah.
Now I've got to say I'm nearly 50.
Yeah.
So
that's it. We have to, you know, the drop down boxes on internet, when you're filling in internet, you have to really scroll now, right, to get to your birth year.
Yeah, and I do those online research things where they give you a few air miles or whatever.
Right.
I get loads less now I've hit 45. I'm not their demographic.
Oh, God. Well, luckily, you're Jack FM's demographic. We love old white men. That's what we want. We want more old white men listening to this. Do you know any more? Do you know any more old white men, Jimbo?
I know plenty of them. Yeah, I'll get them all on this.
Bring them on. Jimbo, nice to talk to you. You've got 45.
Yes.
Tutty byes, thank you. All right, I want to. I feel we've been playing it a little bit safe today. I'm going to wait. We're going to play another game, Will. We're going to wait for a phone call. We're not going to do anything until we get a phone call. These are the moments on radio where you feel alive.
Okay.
Not going to play a song, not going to play anything until we get a phone call. About anything, you can claim an age or you can just phone up, you know, and say, please stop the silence, play a flipping song. Oh, it's Reef next, the Reef Boys. 01-865-575-106. When can they do it, Paul? Oh, hang on a minute. Do you know this is... All right, I'm saying it's Paul. Do you know which Paul this is, Will?
You can do it right now, please.
He's doing a voice.
Yeah. He's doing a voice.
Caller. There's a phone call. Hello, caller.
Good morning.
Good morning. Who's this, please?
This is Steve the Paperboy.
Steve the Paperboy. Hang on a second. You get the round of applause. Well done. Well done, Steve. How may we help you this morning?
Well, I'm just reading to say the lady being rude on the phone to you earlier was Karen, the paper girl.
Oh! She hates me, right?
And she's a big fan of Trevor's, I know.
The thing is, Trevor isn't dead, right? Trevor is not dead. He's on at 3 o'clock. Hang on a minute. You sound like Trevor.
No. I've spoken to Trevor a few times.
Okay, well, it can be done with digital technology. So what is Karen... This is awkward. What is Karen listening to now, then?
Oh, she'll still be listening to you.
She just... Like you say. She said in the message she wasn't going to listen anymore. Oh, man.
She'll phone up in a minute and say, yeah, I'm listening to...
She used a naughty word. Rude. Yeah. Okay, well... thanks for...
As I said in the earlier message, welcome to Morning
Thank you.
Radio.
Thank you very much indeed. I'm feeling shattered already.
There is change, and change is sometimes good.
More often than not, it's a pain in the butt. Would Karen like to claim an age? We have 72 free, if she'd like it.
Ooh. Oh, I think she might be offended if you pulled her that
out. Well, in that case, we shall move swiftly on. Thank you very much indeed. There we go. We got the phone call. It nearly always works, Will. Flippin' Reef, man. Flippin' love Reef.
All right. There's the avenue.
Good morning, lovely jubbly.
Jeez. That was loud, Shafiq. Right, this is Iain Lee's Rude Awakening. Looks like we've made it once again. We've nearly made it. that sounded a little bit sad and desperate. We've nearly made it. Well done. No one died. If you want to give me a call, you can, for the last little bit of the show. 01865. Oh, look at that. Wish and ye shall receive. Good morning, caller.
Oh, hello. It's Ross. I want to be 65.
Who is this?
This is Ross.
Are you actually 65?
No, I want to be 65. Well, I want to swap my age.
Well, hang on. What age are you?
42, dear.
Right, well, you have to be 40. You can't just grab an age.
Oh, I want to be 65.
Well, fingers crossed you'll make it. I mean, it's not guaranteed these days, but, you know, if you... like I'm going to be here in 13 years' time. No, hang on. Jeez, that's 23 years' time. I'm not even going to last 23 months in this gig. Ross, why are you so keen to be 65?
Because I want to be able to just sit at home, watch telly, and then go to bingo, and I want to go on a mystery tour. I've never been on a mystery tour on a coach, and I want to go on a mystery tour.
Do they still do mystery tours on coach? The old charabang?
Yeah.
Okay, well, I think you're allowed to do... All of these things you're saying, you're allowed to do now.
No, because I'll be at work, and I want to be able to just watch Bargain Hunt, Homes Under the Hammer all day.
Who are these people?
Losers. Okay, well, so do you have a job?
At the minute, yes.
Okay, we'll phone them up and pull a sickie today.
Okay, I'll do that. I'm going to blame you if I get sacked, though.
No, you have an Iain Lee Jack FM golden pass, which you can present to your employer. They have to, by law, give you the day off.
Right, I'll definitely do that then, and if I get sacked, then I'm blaming you.
Please do, thank you very much indeed. Okay, there we go. We like to help people. If you want to give us a call, I like these. How does it feel, Will, taking calls straight to air for you?
It's interesting.
Yeah?
Yeah, I like it.
Okay,
I think.
So, try and sound convinced next time. It's interesting. He says... I like it, this is when you feel alive, because, you know, people could come on and, you know, I don't know what they... I don't want to give them ideas. Right, very quickly, right? Brit Boffins, this is a newspaper story. I asked them to get me loads of newspapers, then we haven't even looked at them. So I'm doing this just to justify the expense of them buying newspapers, right? Brit Boffins are building a space weather detector to warn when alien dust is wreaking havoc on Earth. Now, here's my theory, right, Will, and we will discuss this more as the show progresses, right? And this is genuinely my theory. I ain't doing a thing now, right? Okay, this is not a thing. This is...
Not a bit.
This is not a bit. I genuinely... Let's get the music up, because this is important stuff here, right? I genuinely believe that humans... I don't know, a million years ago... The numbers I'm just pulling out of my jacksy. But a million years ago, humans lived on Mars.
Right.
Right? And it was, like, habitable. There was water, there was grass, there were trees, and there was an atmosphere. And then something happened, Will. I don't know what that thing is. Maybe it was a nuclear war. This is a thing. I'm not confused. This is genuinely what I think. Maybe there was a nuclear war. Maybe there was ecological disaster like we're doing here. But we have the technology to fly to Earth. So we flew to Earth. But somewhere along the way, the technology got destroyed and we had to start again from year zero.
My only problem with it is why would they not just on Earth at the first place if it was...
Well, because they lived on Mars.
But if you could say that one was habitable as well,
well,
you could go and live there.
Well, but they... But they lived
before,
on...
Before it comes to an end, you could just go there.
Well, but this is what I'm saying. As it was coming to an end...
Oh, So
there was a war, there was ecological disaster, they went, right, we're gonna go to Earth. Only a few made it to Earth, right? We need to get a science guy on who can back this up. I'm sure this is exactly what who's that man my mum loves? She loves Cox, right? Yeah. We need to get someone like him on because he I think is saying something similar.
I think he might be.
I think he's saying something similar. Well, should I press this button?
Yeah, go
on. Okay, here we go.
Iain Lee's Rude Awakening with STL. Work anywhere with Bullet.
Well, as I like to say, we survived our first encounter, dear listener. Thank you to everyone who listened, everyone who called in, and everyone who doesn't like it as well. You know, this is, you know, thank you. Here's one of the rules of radio, Will. The people that love me listen for an hour. The people that hate me, they listen for 2 hours. It's something about it, right? And, you know, I appreciate this is a huge, huge change for everyone. You've had Trevor in for 15 years. He has not gone away. He's on in the afternoons at 3 o'clock, so you still get to hear him, right? But I appreciate this is a seismic shift in what you are used to. Trevor gave me my first ever break in radio in 1997, I think it was, maybe 96, at a station in Milton Keynes. So I kind of, actually, this is his fault, right? So don't be angry with me, be angry with Trevor. If he hadn't given me that break, I wouldn't be here now replacing him. So it's not my fault, it's his. Will, marks out of 10 for today's show, be honest.
6.5.
Brutal. When I said be honest, I didn't mean it. We will be back tomorrow at 7 o'clock. Well, I think I've not walked into the office yet. I may get my marching orders. So all it remains for me to say is Alexa, jack off.
Jack FM traffic. Driven.